To take your photography to the next level, you need to understand that your viewer's eyes are inherently more interested in the parts of your image that are sharp than the parts that are blurry. When everything is in focus, like in this landscape shot from my smartphone, your eyes are not sure where they should go. I fear there is some visual competition here between the rocks and the cascades in the foreground and those rich yellow trees in the back. Pay attention throughout this tutorial to how your eyes move around as I explain how the lens blur tool here in Snapseed from Google works. I'm going to go to the Tools and Filters icon to bring up the main menu. Next, I'll tap here to launch the lens blur filter. When the lens blur filter loads, you will see two white circles and a blue dot in the middle. Right now, the lens blur filter is in elliptical mode, which is great for some images, but not what I want for this kind of landscape shot. So I'll tap right here to switch from elliptical mode to linear mode. I'm going to slide one finger now from left to right across the screen to increase the blur strength, so you can see what this filter really does. Now, I'm going to press my thumb and forefinger against the screen at the same time and use that pinch in move to bring all these lines closer together. The blue edit pin here represents the center of the unblurred part of my photo. As you look out and away from the blue pin, the first set of lines represents the area where the blur effect begins to happen. As you just saw a minute ago, we can expand or contract that zone with a pinch. We can also rotate the direction of the blur filter by pivoting with two fingers against the screen. I can also reposition the whole filter by tapping on the blue pin with one finger and dragging it up or down. If I tap on the word adjust now, or swipe one finger vertically against the screen, a menu will appear. I'm going to lower the blur strength a little bit, then I'm going to slide down to the transition control in this menu. The transition control here is the space between the inner white line and the outer white lines. If you push these lines further apart by setting a longer transition, then there is more of a gradual shift between the crisp and the blurred zones. The transition controls the distance of the fade between the in focus and the now out of focus areas. If you shorten up the distance between these lines by setting the transition slider down to a lower number, then you're reducing the space between the blurred and the unblurred parts of the image. In this case, and in most photos, long, smooth transitions look more natural, and they are closer mimicked to the way that depth of field actually works with a digital camera. Let me commit these changes now by tapping on the check mark down there in the bottom right corner to prove a point. When you look at this image right now, I have no doubt that your attention is locking on to that little cascade in the bottom middle portion of my frame. I know that your attention is being held right along that plane in this image because that is now the area of crisp detail. And although the cliff wall and those trees in the background are a pretty color, they no longer hold your attention. Watch what happens when I press and hold one finger against the screen to show you the original image. Isn't that amazing? Do you see how when everything is sharp here, your eyes are suddenly free to wander all around the frame? Now, you might like the original image better, but you have to admit that once I add the blur effect, that I am effectively locking your attention onto one specific part of the photo. Let me open up another example, and I'll show you this again, but this time using the elliptical blur option. I love shooting photos in airports. It's one of my favorite ways to pass the time while I'm traveling. You should know, though, that right now, all of the popular smartphones on the market use a fixed aperture lens. The lens in my phone is manufactured with only one aperture setting, which means there is no way for me to limit the depth of field when I'm shooting a big wide-angle scene like this with my smartphone. Since I can't limit the area of crisp detail in this kind of photo when I'm shooting with my phone, I need tools like the lens blur filter in Snapseed to push your attention around after I have captured a strong, sharp image. This time, though, I'm going to stick with elliptical mode because I want to narrow your attention down to that airplane that's at the gate and the fuel truck almost all the way to the back of this photo. First, I'm going to drag that blue edit pin up over the airplane. Next, I'm going to pinch in with two fingers to set a smaller area where the blurring is going to happen. Now, I'm going to pivot my ellipse around using two fingers on the screen and a twist move at the same time. Now, I'm going to slide my finger across the screen to increase the blur strength. Next, I'll tap on the adjust button to bring up the filter menu again, and I'll drop the transition down a little bit. I didn't mention this on the last example, but there is also a vignette option in here that darkens down the blurred area. In this case, I don't think I need the blurred parts of this image any darker, so I'll set this one all the way down to zero. I'll commit my changes again, and once more, let me show you how powerful this filter can be as a storytelling device. In the original image, are your eyes drawn to those baggage carts down there at the bottom of the frame? But once they and everything else becomes blurry, do your eyes walk right past them and all the other stuff and lock right onto that airplane and the fuel truck at the very back of my frame? This is the power of limiting the depth of field or the zone of sharp focus in a photograph. Want to see one more trick? Here, I'm going to open up another image. Now, this one was shot with my big camera. I was lucky enough to be in Nashville, Tennessee once when the glass artist Bruce Monroe had a huge lighted exhibit at the beautiful Cheekwood Botanical Gardens. Bruce and his team had covered the grounds of the Botanical Gardens with these amazing lights and other types of illuminated art. I shot this photo with my DSLR as night was falling. So here's the trick. I'm going to bring up the tools and filters. I'm going to go into lens blur. Then I'm going to switch to the linear mode again. Now I'm going to drag that edit pin up so that those buildings and the people in the background aren't going to be blurred. Next, I'm going to kick the blur strength all the way up, and then I'm going to turn the vignetting off. As you can see, all of those light bulbs have now become blobs of color. In photography, we use the term bokeh to describe the shape and quality of those blobby dots. The thing is that most fancy camera lenses do not produce perfectly round circles when they throw something out of focus. Most DSLR lenses in a scene like this would produce blobs that were more of an octagonal shape. So check this out. If I tap on the toolbar down here where it says style, it turns out that there are 11 different shapes that Snapseed can create when it generates the lens blur. I think that numbers 5 or 6 are a more realistic match for what a DSLR lens would do to a scene like this. Now that's pretty cool, and most of the time, these are the settings that I pick for this style. In all honesty, I picked this image and I cranked the blur strength all the way up here to make this feature really obvious for you. This style choice will not be as noticeable on most images, but it really stands out in a scene like this where you have little points of light up against a super dark background. Now, if you're looking for something different, then watch what happens to my blobs, technically the shape of my bokeh, when I pick one of the star-shaped options instead. Wow. Maybe once a year, say for Valentine's Day, using that heart-shaped choice, number 11, will give you the kind of, oh, love bokeh that no camera lens can create without fancy filters or other crazy tricks. The oh, love look is just too much for me here. So I'm going to switch back down to that star again. But I want to point one more thing out. If I change the transition length, do you see now how the shape and size of the bokeh changes? Let me commit these changes. Finally, if I zoom in using the two-finger pinch and zoom trick, can you see how Snapseed is automatically scaling the size of these stars down as you move closer and closer to the horizon line in this image? We may have gone too silly here, but this is some pretty amazing technology. The point is, when used well, this lens blur filter is an invaluable tool for anyone who wants to make their mobile images even stronger.